Take action, grab your potential lead's attention right when they visit your page, then do a temperature check and casually let them know they have options, what's available, and speak to their interests based off of their past consumer behavior and history. I'm talking about pop-ups and sticky bars, people. I'm Adam Arkfeld, owner of ParaCore, a pay-per-click lead generation agency. This is the 8th of 9 videos in my ridiculously simple guide using Unbounce, an online landing page builder. This is a comprehensive video series focused on helping marketers like you dominate the marketing industry by using Unbounce to convert more prospects with relevant landing pages. If you want to skip ahead to a specific section in the video, check out the description below. I've included an outline with time-stamped links. Popups and sticky bars are two Unbounce tools used to elicit an action from your site visitor. The end goal being to get more leads, signups, and sales. The majority of visitors to a landing page or website don't end up converting. This means that pop-ups and sticky bars are a huge marketing tool because you've done a ton of work to get potential prospects to your digital estate. They're extra tools to help convert visitors while they're still on your page. A pop-up is a box that appears when a visitor is navigating or reading the content on your site. For example, a newsletter sign-up sheet. A sticky bar is a banner that appears at the top or bottom of your webpage. It remains in place as the visitor navigates your site and is slightly less intrusive counterpart to the pop-up. An example of this would be a sale within a Shop Now call to action. From the pop-ups and sticky bars page of your account or your client's account, you can edit the design of current pop-ups or copy them to a client from the drop-down menu. Unbounce makes it simple and easy to create a new pop-up or sticky bar with several templates to choose from if you need inspiration or ideas. Otherwise, you can start with a blank pop-up or sticky bar to get your branding just right. As with the landing page templates, these pop-up templates are separated into subcategories by purpose and motivation. Huge time saver, thanks, Unbounce! Whether you choose a template or go blank, you start dragging and dropping text, image, and the like into the pop-up. Once you've completed and saved the design, you move on to the overview screen. This is where you can customize triggers and targeting rules for your pop-up or sticky bar. You can control who sees your offers and when. That way, you can serve the most relevant offers to the right audience. This example is a pop-up offer for a downloadable asset, my CallRail ebook guide. We recently created a comprehensive video series for CallRail's call tracking software. If you've been enjoying this series, you should check out that one in the link below. From the overview page, you can target by URL, meaning you pick the website, landing page, or group of pages where the pop-up will be seen. In this example, I'm placing it on our site, paracore.com. I don't want this on every page of my website because that could be super annoying. Instead, I'm going to target those people that I know are interested in CallRail. How do I know they're interested? Well, they've been viewing one of our pages about CallRail. So I use the URL path that contains CallRail to only target those pages. You can target URLs that contain, match, start with, or end with any text. Setting up the trigger is the fun part. The trigger allows you to launch pop-ups and sticky bars when visitors arrive on a page, abandon a page, click an element, scroll down a page, or after a set time delay. In this example, I set a trigger for a 10-second delay. That means after 10 seconds of being on my blog page, the visitor will see this pop-up offer to download my ebook. I can also set it to pop up when they scroll to a specific percentage down the page. This is also an opportunity for one last attempt to capture a lead before they leave. The one minor setback when a visitor tries to exit the page is that the trigger doesn't work on touchscreen mobile devices. Bummer, dude. Next is frequency, which is highly important because you don't want to drive visitors off your website by being too pushy with your pop-ups and sticky bars. You want to woo your visitors. If you come on too strong, too fast, they'll bolt. So just relax and take it slow. Set the pop-up to once per visitor, or like I did on this pop-up, show the pop-up every 2 visits. Okay, now we're going to take it up a notch with advanced targeting. You have your choice of 4 advanced targeting options, targeting by location, by cookies, referring URL, or by date. Before we go any further, know that these advanced options are only available with the premium and higher plans. Targeting by location is best for getting your regional offers in front of the right visitors by targeting those visitors who live in a specific city or country. You can also exclude visitors who live in a specific city or country. For example, if you sell bikinis and there isn't a market for bikinis in Antarctica, which there isn't, where the average weather is 15 degrees Celsius in the summertime, you want to exclude visitors in Antarctica if you're advertising there for some reason. The next advanced option is targeting with cookies. With this option, you can show or hide pop-ups and sticky bars to visitors based on their browsing history, conversion status, previous actions, and much more. This is based on the presence of a cookie stored in a visitor's browser. Currently, you can only target by cookie name and not the cookie value. you would use this option to prevent current customers who may have already purchased a product from seeing ads for that same product. Another advanced option is to target by referring URL. This option allows you to show different pop-ups and sticky bars to visitors from different traffic sources. For example, Facebook, AdWords, or an organic search. The final advanced option is to target by date range. This one is self-explanatory. When do you want your pop-up to start and end? Schedule your sticky bars or pop-ups to start and stop according to promotion or seasonal campaign. You can also do all the same integrations with pop-ups and sticky bars that you do with landing pages. You can automatically pass leads from pop-ups to your favorite email, analytics, or marketing automation tool like MailChimp or Marketo or HubSpot. After you customize all of your triggers and targeting rules, copy the embed code, paste it where it needs to go, and boom, you've got pop-ups and sticky bars. Lastly, you can increase conversions by making the content automatically adapt to what visitors are searching for. It's called dynamic text replacement, and it's one fancy feature in Unbounce, which I talk about in the next video. It's definitely one you don't want to miss, so make sure you click that red subscribe button to be notified the second I release a new video. If you have any questions or need some direction, I'm your man. Just leave a comment or question below, and I'll see you in the next video.